This is a Cameo tutorial on how to remove your water-soluble thread on your embroidery.
When you are working with a water-soluble, you need to also remember if you're going to use it later. Like in many of my pieces, I use the water-soluble to give alignment marks in like design a line when you're putting blocks together. This blocking process is done after all of the construction is done. So if you have another round to go on this piece, you do not want to remove the water soluble until you're completely done with the whole project.
My career comes from basically long arming and doing freeform kind of work. And some of the biggest problems I had with that is when I would do trapunto and I would try to get the water soluble thread out. Well, the normal way of doing that step in any of the quilt work is to actually just spray it with water. That can get you into a lot of trouble if your fabrics are bleeding or there's just all sorts of craziness with that. When I went into embroidery, I came in knowing that you are not supposed to ever spray anything with water. It has to be in a controlled way that you remove whatever it is that you want to remove. So as the embroidery moved on and my techniques got a little bit more clear and more precise, this technique of removing the water-soluble thread was evolved within that because I know better than to spray anything whatsoever. And water-soluble thread is meant to help you stabilize things, and it's really an important thing, and it shouldn't be a step that is an annoyance. It is there to support what you need to do. To do this technique, you will need a hand towel, and this is, you don't want a washcloth. You want a hand towel, and it needs to be this size. Now, the towel needs to be perfectly clean, so you can either buy new ones and keep bleaching them, whatever that is for you, but we need to make sure that it's clean so there's no residue, because when we do this step, that water-soluble glue that is inside either your stabilizers or your water-soluble thread will actually get into the towel, so we want to keep it very clean. When I'm doing this on a quilt, I will actually use 4 or 5 towels at a time, wash them, and then start all over again because the towel is absorbing that water-soluble thread, and it just works so well. I have this towel, and what you want to do is you have a dry towel, and this side of the towel is dry, and this side is wet. So I go to the sink, and I just wet one half of the towel, and I wring it as hard as I can to get most of the moisture out. Then I fold it in half and put the dry part of the towel to the inside, and then I wring it again. And what happens is that that excess moisture that would cause you a problem now goes into the dry side of the towel. So we want to make sure that you wring it into it and smooth it out, and that gives you the perfect amount of moisture in your towel all the way around. So it's really important to not have too much, but you have to have enough. Now, I want to go over why it's important to have a terry cloth towel. We're working with embroidery, and there's lots of dimension on embroidery. Now, in regular sewing, we would use maybe a press cloth because we want it to be really, really flat. Like if I'm doing machine applique and it's only a top, I will use a press cloth, not a terry cloth. The terry cloth gives you just a little bit of puff so it'll go in those crevices of the stitches and not push the stitches really flat and damage the actual embroidery. So it's a really important part to use that terry cloth. When you're doing embroidery, not even specifically mine or other people, there are always places that it's going to wobble and do crazy things. Now, most people will never wash the embroidered quilts, but we want to remove the water-soluble thread so that you can enjoy the piece. And there is no other way of doing it that really works as well. If you spray it, sometimes it comes out, sometimes it doesn't. It's really unpredictable. But we want to take our towel, and you want to make sure that it is the appropriate amount of wet. And you want to work within a controlled area so you won't forget where you're at. I'm going to place the towel over the top of the embroidery, make sure it's as square as it can be, and you want to take a hot iron. And when the iron hits the towel, you're going to hear a sizzle. And if you don't hear that sizzle, that's when you need more water on your towel. So you want to press it, and you want to take it really slow. You don't want to do it too fast, because if you get too much water into your piece, it creates a problem too. So you may have to do this a couple of times if there are pretty intense water-soluble stitching. Normally there isn't, but you want that as an option. So we've pressed this,
and I want to remove it. And what you have now is a very, very flat piece. Do not press it dry. Let it dry naturally. And if, in fact, there is still water-soluble thread in that space, just do it again. If I'm working with a really delicate fabric, I like to let it dry before I go back and repeat the pressing to get the water-soluble thread out. I've pressed this 3 or 4 times. The thing that you need to remember is that your water-soluble thread needs to be the light water-soluble, not the heavy. And you also want to make sure that you do the pressing enough times that the actual water-soluble thread dissolves. So that can be depending on your work and the water-soluble thread and how old your thread is. There's too many variables. So you want to do it until the water-soluble thread actually goes away. So it could be 2 times, but it also could be more than that. So this depends on what thread you're actually using. In the corners where there's excess, you can go ahead and do it again until the thread goes away. But what you also want to do is turn it over and do it from the back side, which is this. Now we have some water-soluble thread right here and stabilizer. That also can be done in the same way. But when you go to the back, you can put it on there also, because remember the thread goes from the front to the back, and we used it in the bobbin. Now most of the water-soluble thread on the filigree work is on the inside here, but you want to make sure that you get rid of it on the back side and the front side. When you're working on the filigree work and or anything that's been appliqued and you've used stabilizer, and this is for the water-soluble stabilizer, many times it'll leave just like a white line. And this stabilizer is water-soluble. You want to get your hand towel nice and wet. It's not too saturated. Just make sure that it's good and moist. And you put it on top of your filigree or whatever you're trying to move that the stabilizer away. And the stabilizer actually is more intense than the water-soluble thread. So you may have to do it more times than you would think. But we want to go ahead and press it. And you want to hear that sizzle. That tells you you have enough water. And if you look at it, you can see that it is melting. That right there, and it took 2 times for me to do it with a nice moist towel, and it removed all that water soluble that was right next to that seam. And it's really gone. I'm actually pulling out the alignment thread that we used. And your water soluble is all gone at that seam. I finished cleaning up all the water-soluble thread, and you just need to remember that if it's built up, or depending on the brittleness of your water-soluble thread, it may take you 3 or 4 times blocking it with the hand towel to get that water-soluble thread out. And you want to make sure that you do not spray your piece. You need to remove it with the hand towel.